replacing number two.
Yeah.
Pick up everything, kind of the knowledge.
You keep the question.
And we're going to ask that you kind of keep the questions brief, just for translation sake. Alan is translating tonight, and we welcome the man that finished off HBO Boxing After Dark tonight with an impressive knockout over formerly unbeaten Thomas DeLorme in welterweight bout. Fifth straight win, all by knockout, correct? I believe.
Sí, cinco peleas.
Now 34-1 with 28 knockouts, Carlos Abreu. And if you want to start, maybe Carlos, with a few comments about the fight.
¿Tú quieres decir algo?
Any questions?
¿Quién?
¿Quieres decir algo de la pelea?
Bueno, la verdad, muy contento, ¿no?, por este desarrollo, por cómo terminó la pelea. La verdad que desde un principio con el equipo aceptamos la pelea porque, bueno, teníamos toda la certeza de que la pelea iba a terminar de esta manera.
Of course, he said, you know, he was happy with the decision of taking the fight. It was in good preparation with the team. We knew that we can come out victorious with fighting Thomas DeLorme.
Questions?
Briggs? Where do you see this putting you in the division? Your only loss is to a pretty top guy. You kind of just took care of a guy that was up and coming. So who do you think would be a next good, feasible guy to advance your career against?
¿Dónde estuve poniendo? ¿En qué posición te está poniendo esto? ¿Te gana? ¿Con quién tú quieras pelear?
Bueno, la verdad que creo que este título es importante para mí y bueno, creo que me pone en un buen nivel, se puede decir. No debería decir, debería estar primero, ¿no? Porque le gané al primero del consejo. Bueno, yo debería ocupar ese lugar ahora, así que espero que esté primero y esté me tengan en cuenta primero en la lista también para pelear con los campeones, ¿no? Pero bueno, antes que nada me gustaría pelear con Tim Bradley, que bueno, aquella noche tuve una mala suerte de no estar bien de mi mano derecha y ahora quisiera revertir ese fallo que tuve esa vez, ¿no?
Of course, he said this is an important title that he just won. I mean, of course, this should put him at number one, the WBC title. And of course, the rematch that he would like to see it would be with Timothy Bradley, being that his first fight, you know, his right hand was hurt, and now that it's 100%, we want to get a rematch with him, you know, so he can get, you know, he wants a rematch. That's just the bottom line.
Nestor Gibbs with theboxingvoice.com.
Excuse me.
Nestor Gibbs with theboxingvoice.com.
How you doing?
This championship fight tonight puts him number one ranked WBC. In the WBC, they're going to have a fight with Robert De Ghost Guerrero versus Andre Berto. Would he like the winner of that?
Okay, esta corre te pone en nivel primero. And tenemos una pelea que viene de con Berto. What's the other guy's name?
Robert De Ghost Guerrero.
Robert De Ghost Guerrero y Berto. ¿Quién te gustaría pelear de esos dos?
La verdad, con cualquiera. Los vi pelear a los dos. Pero bueno, me gustaría pelear con Guerrero, ¿no? Creo que es un poco más chico de tamaño y... Pero bueno, si me toca con Berto también, creo que de acá al más seguimos con la preparación fuerte y creo que todo depende por un buen trabajo físico y técnico para pelear con estos campeones, ¿no?
He said he would like to fight Guerrero, but at the end of the day he'll fight either one, him or Berto. He said, as far as the preparation, everything is good, and we've been working on conditioning and technique, and we're ready to fight anyway.
Your fellow countryman, Sergio Martinez, suffered a loss early in his career, and unfortunately in this business, one loss can put you on the trash. He since has had a resurgence like no one has in a very long time. Think that you can similarly have that type of resurgence like Sergio Martinez did?
Sergio sufrió una de derrota temprano en su carrera. Y si tú crees, you know, y ahora está bien caliente, está ganando. Si tú crees que tú puedes hacer lo mismo.
Sí, la verdad que eso pasó con maravilla, ¿no? Perdió a su principio de la carrera. Y bueno, ojalá me toque pasar esa situación a mí también. La verdad que él, después de esa derrota, se hizo más fuerte física y mentalmente. Vimos una maravilla diferente hasta el día de hoy, ¿no?
He said, of course, he would like nothing more than to be just like him. I mean, after that loss that he took, he got stronger and better. So he would have no problem with simulating the same thing.
Igual, y eso me pasó a mí también, que me hice más fuerte.
He took a loss also in early. Well, not as early, but early, and it made him stronger. And it's got him to this point right here, where he's a WC champ, ranked number one.
Can you ask him what he thinks it's going to take, what type of performance is he going to have to give to have his name mentioned with the rest of the Argentine fighters to fight here in the United States, you know, to be named with the Lucas Matisse's of the world, Marcos McDonald, Sergio Martinez, and of course, Carlo Monzon?
¿Qué clase de pelea que tú vas a tener que tirar? Para que este público te considere como una Maidana o Martina o Moisés.
Bueno, no sé a quién tendría que ganarle. Capaz que, creo que, como decía hace rato, necesito tener la revancha con Tim Bradley para demostrar que esa vez no estaba bien yo y que ahora puedo ganarle a él. Y primero, porque ya lo conozco, y bueno, y segundo, que él no puede ganar, no va a poder ganarme a mí. Así que bueno, creo que sería una buena oportunidad para demostrar que yo estoy al nivel de estos campeones, ¿no?
He said, yeah, he wants to start that by getting the rematch with Timothy Bradley so he can prove to the world that he can beat him. And the reason why he didn't perform as well is because he was injured. And, you know, with that performance, that should put him on the next level.
Tomás Valverde, creo que si estaba primero en el ranking es por algo. No le gané a Don Nadie, le gané a Tomás Valverde, que estaba primero en el ranking del Consejo y también estaba dentro de los primeros en los otros rankings, así que creo que eso es importante también.
He said Tomás Valverde was ranking number one also, so, I mean, if that's a sum of importance to his performance as well. I mean, he's ranking number one in a lot of areas, and he wasn't just no slouch. You know?
Does he understand that the WBC is its own sanctioning body, and that Timothy Bradley, along with other champions in the welterweight division, are sanctioned with another sanctioning body? So this win doesn't necessarily mean that it would be enough to get him a Timothy Bradley fight.
En la Corea de la WBC es una sanción diferente que de la que está con Timothy Bradley. Que no necesariamente quiere decir que tiene esa Corea que le van a dar una pelea con Timothy Bradley.
Bueno, si no es con Timothy Bradley, que sea con Pacquiao o Mayweather. No sé. En este momento puedo decir que me siento muy bien, tengo un equipo sólido que trabaja para mí y bueno, tengo la confianza, tenemos la confianza para desafiar a cualquier campeón, ¿no?
¿Cuál fue la clave de la victoria esta noche?
Bueno, la clave de la victoria fue, estuvo acá la mano derecha. Creo que cuando entró la mano derecha no resistió el golpe y el tipo se fue al piso y de ahí no se recuperó más.
Well, the key was the right hand, is what he was telling me. He asked him in Spanish, what was the key to the fight? He said the key was the right hand. That right hand that was hurt, it was 100%. This time he used it and made him, you know, came out with the victory. And what he said before was that, if not Bradley, then Mayweather or Pacquiao. I mean, he's willing to fight anybody. He said you got a good team. I mean, we had a great team. We're putting things together and we ready for whatever's coming.
Did he feel that
Romero
totally recovered early on?
Tú sentiste que Tomás recuperó más temprano en la pelea.
No, él estaba cuando entró en la derecha y se fue al piso. A partir de ese momento él no se perdió. quiso cambiar la estrategia un poco cuando se puso de zurdo, pero bueno, era cuestión de esperar un poco cuando hasta que le llegue de nuevo la derecha y bueno, se iba a ir al piso.
He said when he landed the right hand and he got up, he can tell he was lost. He changed his strategy. He tried to go southpaw, and I just remained patient and just waited for the right time, and that was it.
Any other questions?
Yeah, I was speaking to Virgil Hunter, and he said that the difference in the fight was that Abregu was a man, and that Delorme was a boy, and that Abregu was able to manhandle him and push him off of him and just be the bigger fighter. Does he feel that that's correct?
Who's the guy, Virgil Hunter?
Yeah.
I hablo con Virgil Hunter, y que dijo que la diferencia en la pelea era que tú eres un hombre y el tipo un chamaquito. Y que tú lo empujaste y controlaste con tú eres un hombre, lo empujaste por todos lados.
Sí, también tenía que ver eso, ¿no? Yo soy una persona mucho más madura que él, tengo mucho más experiencia, hice peleas duras, ¿no? Con David Estrada, con Irving García, con Richard Gutiérrez, bueno, Tim Bradley, creo que esas peleas fueron bastante duras. Y eso me dio la experiencia a mí para manejar la pelea, se puede decir, hoy con Tomo Dolor.
Of course, I mean, I was the strongest fighter. ¿Cómo se llama la palabra esa?
Richard Gutiérrez.
I fought with Richard Gutiérrez.
David Estrada.
David Estrada.
Irving García.
Timothy Bradley. Of course, I have more experience than he does, so. More experience than he does in that area, and of course I was a strong man, and that makes a difference.
You think you knew he was hurt bad last round? I mean, it looked like, could you tell? It looked like you were sensing that he was pretty much out. You know, the round was winding down.
En el último asalto, ¿tú te diste cuenta que estaba bien herido?
Sí, bueno. Le veía los ojos cuando después de la primera caída. Y ahí me di cuenta de que, bueno, me apresuré un poco y bueno, llegué al rincón y el equipo me dijo que me tranquilizara, que era cuestión de esperar. Había tiempo todavía y bueno, esperé el momento y bueno, y ahí llegó la definición.
When I knocked him down, he got up, you can see in his eyes that he was in la la land. But I didn't get desperate, I went to the corner, my corner told me to take it easy and relax and be patient, and that's exactly what I did.
Anything else? All right. Thank you, Carlos. Mind your team up here. We could have you pose for a photo if anybody wants to get a photo of
yes.
Carlos.
Bueno, muchas gracias a ustedes, HBO y bueno, a Gary Show. En principio no quiero convocó para esta pelea.
Thank you, HBO, Gary Show, and everybody that set up the fight.
You know, but wherever I have to fight, I'm ready to fight. Whether it's on the road or in my hometown, ideally I'd like to fight there.
Can you get your promoter to put a card out in your hometown?
We definitely can get a promoter to put out a card out there. We originally I was supposed to fight Mauricio Herrera in the Bay Area, but due to a back injury, he pulled out and that sort of messed up the whole card. But nevertheless, I would like to fight there. But I'm willing to fight on enemy territory wherever I got to fight. I'm willing to fight there and be victorious wherever I have to be.
Any more questions?
This is a WBO fight, right? So your ranking will move up in the WBO.
It will definitely move up the WBO and ABF, the little NABF thingy, medallion. But yeah, so my ranking definitely should move up, sure.
Thank you.
Hard hitter.
Thank you, Kareem.
Hard hitter.